not really my drink, you know.
I know, Astarion. You prefer blood.
Yes. It was a joke.
I know that too. It just wasn't funny.
What's in here?
Research notes. They describe a powerful venom extracted from a rare purple worm. Distiller Thisible Thorm sought to create a fatal poison using the worm's gullet. He procured several parts of a worm gullet, but rinsed one in error. The poison he brewed was noxious, but not fatal. Thisible devoted months to formulating a deadly poison with the remaining ingredients, without success. After exhaustive experimentation, he was able to make a near-deadly extract from the glands. But to complete his poison, Thisibald required one last ingredient, the petals of a corpse rose. The book's index reveals corpse roses may grow near tombs, mausoleums, and particularly redolent cadavers. Thisibald enlisted a courier from Baldur's Gate to obtain corpse rose petals and other ingredients and deliver them to a covert location. Unfortunately, a deep purple stain darkens the final page, obscuring the parcel's destination. Your mind separates the black from the blue, revealing the stash's location. You mark your map as a reminder. With the corpse rose petals the package contains, you might create Thisibald's purple worm poison.
hardly a challenge.
Is that blood? No, never mind. One day I'll catch a break. On everything. What's hiding here?
Let's crack it open.
Let's get going. Time to press ahead. Anything of use? I'll take that.
We're close. I can feel it. The Absolute. Its power is strong here.
Seems simple enough.
watch your back. Should be easy.
Still alive, so that's progress. On my way. Wish I had a bag of holding. What's inside? See that symbol on the ground? This was a mason's guild.
These masons met a most violent end, judging by the impaled skeletons there.
Oh, hi.
Let this be a warning. Those who defy Shah's will shall suffer darkness without her blessing. Here lies the Grand Mason, his bones and lies exposed. A pile of crushed bones of varying shapes, sizes, and creatures.
well that ends not as bad as it could have. These boots have seen everything. On my mind and, well, in it. Moving ahead. Anything of use?
Happy place. I'm going to enjoy this.
Turn someone inside out.
Right, Karlak, it's go time. Is gonna fall. Huh!
Clung to this soul's breath. He was insensible when the shadows came for him.
Always room for more?
Step quick. Let's have it. Interesting maps. Especially that nice big X at the base of Moonrise Tower.
like a hospital. Or a healer's house, anyway.
The psionic detector is sounding. Vlakith's warriors are upon us.
now?
Let's see. What's this?
Never a dull moment.
Kill you. I won't make the same mistake.
No one back home will ever believe this.
It is as we knew. My people have turned their blades against us. They will emerge from the shadows and descend from the skies. And we will grant them their only just fate. Death. That should more than suffice.
What's cooking? Let's march!
Long road ahead. I need to find a way forward. What's up for discussion?
Good evening. I'm here on behalf of Gale of Waterdeep. He wishes to extend you an invitation for a private conversation in a more suitable locale. Gladly. Simply follow yonder path, and soon you will find him.
I love this time of night. There's an almost reverent silence that accompanies the peak of darkness, when you'd almost believe the dawn will never break. The cradle of eternity. The timelessness of lovers. That most beautiful of fantasies.
I will be. Soon. I am perhaps just one hard day away from being without any troubles at all. This may be my last night alive. I wanted it to be under a canopy of beauty and wonder. I thought this place might bring me peace. I thought it might make the weight of what I must do feel a little lighter. But I'm not so sure.
Babe or crone, coward or hero, death is assured. Mistra's forgiveness is not. If you knew the end was near, would you not want to ensure it had meaning? I am terrified. I will not claim otherwise. My face could scarcely conceal it, even if my words sought to deny it. There is no point in running from the inevitable. Better to meet it on my own terms.
Yes. But there is so much to live for, and so few moments in which to house it all. Damn you. Damn you for giving me so much to care about. Our friends, our adventures. This would have been so much easier if it was just me. But it isn't. If there is a way, any way, to save all that's grown dear to me, I want to seize it. I just cannot fathom what that might be, other than to fail Mistra and condemn the world. Stay with me, will you? I don't want to think of it anymore, but I don't want to be alone either.